In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you this morning and thank you, Lord, that when we are in your presence, every mountain melts like wax. Thank you, Lord, that as we are learning more about you, seeking more of you, Lord, you said that when we seek more, we are the righteousness and everything is added unto us. Thank you, O Holy Spirit of God, for making everything that we are going to learn today very simple and easy to understand and easy to apply. Follow the instructions and see the manifestations, see the breakthroughs in our lives. Lord, as I submit myself right now into your most holy hands, I diminish and you increase. And all that you want to teach us, we are here ready to listen from you, hear from you, learn from you. Thank you for opening the spiritual hearts, spiritual minds, spiritual senses to accept and acknowledge every word that comes from my mouth. Thank you, Almighty God the Father. This we ask in the most precious and holy name of Jesus. And all God's people said, Amen, Amen, and Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Yeah. Good morning, everyone. So today, I just want to speak about how we can meditate. What is the meaning of meditation in real terms when it comes to the Word of God? Now, when we read a certain, when we read the newspapers, when we read a novel, when we read some article, we read it just once. For the knowledge, to gain knowledge about that particular thing. But when we read for an exam, when we read for an interview, what is our type of reading? We read again and again. Right? So, we will study the difference between reading and studying. We all have to know one thing, that we need to study the Word of God. Many people say, I read my Bible every day. Now, read my Bible every day means you are reading a newspaper every day. You are reading a novel every day. But if you go to study the Bible, then you are preparing yourself for that day, which is actually going to sometime come against you. And now you have become a warrior so great that now that something that has come against you will not even touch you. You will know how to fight that battle. You will know how to cut the head of that Goliath that has come against you. You will not get fearful. And that happens only and only when we study the Word of God. Because now when you study, that scriptures, that words go right deep into your heart and it remains there permanently forever. That is the meaning of study. Now, why do I say permanently? When we were children, did we learn many poems? Do we remember Jack and Jill till today? Or do we have to go and learn it again? If we ask even an old grandma, do you know Jack and Jill? She will forget all other things, like who came yesterday, who phoned me yesterday, who came to see me yesterday, or you know, all that. But she'll remember Jack and Jill. What happened? That went and set right so deep into her heart, because that's why it is known as by heart. That's why we say that we have learned this by heart. So it has gone and settled down in our heart. In the same way, we need to study the word of God. If you come across any scripture, if you come across any teaching on that scripture, and now if you test yourself the next day and you ask yourself, what is it that I learned yesterday? And now if you don't remember that, means you need more training for yourself. See, we have to have competition with ourselves. Never have competition with somebody else. It is always with me. How much more better can I become than yesterday? How much more can I learn than yesterday? How much more can I give than yesterday? How much more can I love than yesterday? How much more can I forgive than yesterday? So have a competition with our own selves. We can judge ourselves. We cannot judge somebody else. We cannot compete with somebody else. But yes, we can compete with ourselves to become a better human being, a better tomorrow for somebody else. So we have to study the word of God. We have to learn the word of God. Joshua chapter 1 and verses 8 says, this book of law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but you shall meditate. Now, in some versions, it also says you shall study. Okay, the meaning of meditation is we are focusing on a particular reading, on a particular chapter, on a particular verse, on a particular line. Just as a very easy example for meditation is a doctor's report, because we can understand only that. So we can understand only when we meditate, you know, when we get a doctor's report. And now the doctor's report is saying, I have got dash, dash, dash. Now, instead of, you know, just saying like, praise the Lord, thank you, Jesus, praise you, Jesus, love you, Jesus, it is like, oh my God, I got dash, 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 dash. Now, from the clinic or from the doctor's place till your house, you are just meditating on that. That is known as meditation. Now, you are focusing on that. And now, you are not only doing that, you are looking at what can happen through that. Okay? In the same way, when we take the word of God, okay, and now when we ponder on that, now we are saying, what can happen through this word of God? For example, if we are taking the word of God, by the wounds and stripes of Jesus, I'm already healed. Even when I can't see that I'm healed, but I'm believing. And now, because I've taken this as my meditation, my scripture to meditate, now I will see what can that bring. So now I am actually imagining my healing. through that word of God, I am imagining that I can do all things. Through that word of God, I am imagining I'm back going to my office. Through that word of God, I imagine I'm going for grocery. I'm going to leave my children at the bus stop. So everything you imagine through that word of God, that is known as meditation in the word of God. Okay. Now, the ERV version of Joshua chapter 1 verses 8 is, always remember what is written in the book of the law. The book of the law means the word of God. Okay. Speak about the book and study it day and night. Speak about the book and study it day and night. So let us understand this. Psalm 19 verse 7. Psalm 19 verse 7 says, the law of the Lord is perfect. That is, the word of God is perfect. Law means the word of God. So the law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple. Now, what is simple? Converting the soul means now, when you are going to take that scripture and going to meditate on that scripture, your soul mind. See, we got two minds. One is the spirit mind, one is the soul mind. As we already know about the spirit, soul, and body. Okay. The spirit mind is always connected to God. The soul mind is what we live on this planet Earth. So now that particular scripture is converting the soul mind. Okay. And now the testimony of the Lord is sure. The testimony is the word of God is sure, making wise the simple. Means the simple people are now getting wiser by the word of God. Okay? Simple means those who are not very intelligent, a person who cannot remember, a person who struggles, a person who's low in his IQ. Okay? A person who a teacher says he cannot understand anything, he needs to be given more attention. So those people are called simple people. Okay? Otherwise, the name is intelligent. Okay? Now, even those simple people, if they take the word of God, that word of God makes those simple people also wise. Okay? So the word of God is perfect. The law of the law is perfect. The word of God converts the soul of a simple person and makes that person wise. It is like a medicine. That medicine of the word will go into your mind, will go into your thoughts, will go into your thinking, into your brain. And that word makes you intelligent, smart, wise, brilliant, and healthy. So this word of God can actually change us from nothing to so much of abundance. Okay? The word of God is alive. This word of God is active. It's powerful. It's operative, energizing. So the word of God, if we take this particular word of God and sow it in our heart, keep it over there. The word of God is Jesus himself. John 1:1 says that. Okay. In the beginning, there was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. So when you put this word of God into your hearts and now you keep meditating, now that word becomes alive, active in you, and your soul mind, that is your flesh, also starts you know, acting as per the word of God. The word of God is a seed. When we see a seed, if we want to, sow a seed in the soil, if we just keep that seed on our hand, we don't even know that seed is going to bring such a big harvest, that one seed. In the same way, when you sow the seed of the word of God into your heart, that one seed is going to get such a big harvest. That one seed. And now the Bible is a book of seeds. It's a full forest. We need to go and take everything that pertains to our life, to our family, to our children, to our workplace, to everything that we need and everything that we need to teach somebody else. So once when you look upon yourself and now you see, today I have studied this particular scripture. Take a revision tomorrow without even looking at the scripture. Yesterday I studied this. Okay, what was that? Now you study one more scripture today. Then tomorrow, okay, last 2 days I studied two scriptures. What was that? Now what are you doing? Taking a revision for yourself and studying one scripture each day, and you are getting better and better in the word of God because now that word is settled in your heart. And now what happens is when somebody tells you to pray, or either even you want to pray for yourself or your children or your family, you take that word of God and now you are making a prayer on based on that word of God. And you know what we are doing when we do that? We are speaking to God back his own word. And when we speak to back the Lord's own word, he understands it more better. See, when we are in India, right? In India, we've seen that there are many languages. We cannot understand certain languages. We can understand only some. We cannot understand all. So when somebody comes and speaks to us a very different language, we can't reciprocate because we don't understand that language. In the same way, when you don't speak the language of faith from the word of God to God, that language is not understood because fear is not understood by God. Instead, he says many a times in his written word, do not fear. Do not fear. What is the meaning of that? He says, can you speak faith? So that language is not understood by the heavenly realm, by the heavenly kingdom. But if you speak faith, and now you said, thank you, Jesus, by your wounds and by your stripes, I am completely healed. Thank you, Lord. I believe and I trust in what I've said. Thank you, Jesus. You have supplied every need of mine. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Your blessings have come upon me and they have overtaken me. Thank you, Jesus. Now, I am speaking scriptures. And when I am speaking scriptures, I am speaking his word back to him. And he has very clearly said that my word will never go void. It will accomplish for what it has sent and come back to me. It is the promise of God. But when we say that same scripture in fear, then, as I said, fear is not recognized. Faith is recognized. Hebrews 11:6 talks about it. So let us understand about meditating on the word of God, keeping that word in our heart. Okay? The more we keep that word in our heart, we see our own lives changing. And from a carnal thinking, we come to a supernatural thinking. The carnal thinking means the thinking of a flesh, where we always keep cribbing, we always keep, you know, like we are not very happy with whatever is going on in us or around us. That is carnal thinking, carnal nature. So we need to have a nature that is little, not little, but way beyond the carnal nature, because we are not belonging to this world. We belong to the heavens. We are citizens of heaven. Once we understand that, once we acknowledge that, that Lord, that this world is not mine, but I belong to the heavenly realms, and now you are doing the work of the heavenly realm. You are doing the work of your Father. And the work of your Father is go and love somebody else. Go and be compassionate to somebody else. Go and teach the word of God to somebody else. Go and take out that person from a dungeon and from that darkness, and bring that person by giving them the truth of the gospel to the marvelous light of the Lord. That is what we are called for. Now, there is a very easy way of, you know, meditation, okay? If you all want to write, please write, and if somebody can put it on the chat, please put, okay? It is God's word that is conceived, okay? That is conceived. God's word that is conceived or planted in my heart. God's word that is conceived or planted in my heart, then, okay, formed by the tongue, then formed by the tongue and spoken out of my own mouth, formed by the tongue and spoken out of my own mouth, becomes a spiritual force, becomes a spiritual force, releasing the ability of God within me. Okay? Becomes a spiritual force, releasing the ability of God within me. Amen? Yeah. Now, this will make it very clear when you want to meditate on something. Now, what is the meaning of this? I'll just explain it, okay? Just as I said, we learned Jack and Jill when we were very small, very young, small children, but yet we remembered it because that is the time our parents took pains to make us understand that particular line, made us repeat it again and again. And, you know, and we went, the moment we did it, we kept it in our hearts and we kept on, listening to that every time, even when we became big, like our children or our cousins, our children's children, they kept on saying. So that became more firm and firm and firm into our hearts. Okay. So in the same way, now, when we say that God's word that is conceived or planted in my heart, now, once you look at the word of God, see, many of us, we tend, as I said earlier, we read the Bible. Okay, now when we read the Bible, it becomes external. It becomes like I read a newspaper, like I read a novel, right? Like I read a pamphlet. Okay, that is known as reading. But now when you conceive that in your heart, now how can you conceive it even before putting it out of your mouth? When you are looking at a particular scripture, that particular scripture is giving you your vision. Okay, now when that scripture gives you your vision, now you are actually looking at that vision when you are looking at that scripture. Like, for example, Joel 3:10 says, let the weak say, I am strong. Now somebody is very weak. Okay, and now that person remembers Joel 3:10. And now the person says, thank you, Jesus. For you said, let the weak say, I am strong. I declare right now that I am strong. So what did you do even before declaring? You visualized yourself. You pondered on that verse. before you, and now you have opened your mouth, you have formed that in your tongue, okay? You have formed that in your tongue, and you have spoken it out of your own mouth. You have spoken it out of your own mouth. So when you do that, and now you are having the word of God, now that word of God becomes a spiritual force, because what did you do? When you've seen the word of God, you have kept that word of God in front of your eye, you have visualized yourself, no, I am not weak. This happens to many people when they do night duties and day duties at the same time. They feel that they are very weak. This happens to many people who give the word of God to many people at the, you know, like when somebody gives them a call every time. So they cannot say no, because it is the word of God. They need to give it. They cannot say, no, I'm feeling sleepy today. You please call me tomorrow. No, any warrior in the kingdom of God will never ever put anybody down. Okay, so that person is going to, when that person gives the word of God, and now that person is even sleepy, or maybe somebody has done a double shift, and now that person is like tired, I can't do more. But if that person takes the scripture and say, Lord, it is by your strength. You said, Lord, let the weak say I am strong. Right now, I take this and I declare it by my mouth that I am strong. I am not weak anymore. And supernaturally, you get that force within you. And that is known as that word becomes a spiritual force, releasing the ability of God. It is now no more you, but your God has actually helped you. And that's why we hear many people saying, you know, I just said this and that happened. How? Because it was not your accord. It was your Lord, your God and your Savior, that ability came in you. And now you were able to fulfill that particular work, which was not able to. I remember an instance right now, what happened in my life, okay? And that time I was not in the word of God. It became a sad situation where my daddy, he was not well. And he was on the bed, okay? My mom, she had to sleep on the ground because daddy was on the bed. Sorry. And mommy cannot sleep on the ground anytime. She has never slept on the ground because the ground is cold and she would get cramps. Because of her, we had made that single bed into a double bed by calling a carpenter. But now because daddy was on the bed, we couldn't pull that bed out, which went underneath, which the carpenter made new. We couldn't pull it out, okay? What happened is, my mom got a cramp again in her leg. And now she couldn't bear it. And now I literally had to, and I was alone. I literally had to somehow manage her and make her sit on a chair. Now, when she was sitting on a chair, it was not a chair actually, it was a stool, okay? When she was sitting on that, she felt unconscious. And now daddy was on the bed and daddy was with fever. He had high fever. I had to look at him, and now she fell unconscious and she's on a stool. I had to look at her because in her unconscious state, I didn't want her to fall down. So I had to change daddy's, that drips, na, what we say. I had to change that also. And plus I had to do this. And both were in different, like not sitting at the same place. I couldn't manage both at one time. Either I go to mom one time or either I go to dad one time. And now she was like, you know, already unconscious, not coming to her senses. It was 2 a.m. in the morning, and I didn't know, I didn't want to disturb my sister that time. And I just tried to push her towards the wall so that she can get, you know, how we push something towards the wall so that they they can actually, that thing never falls down. In the same way, I tried it with her, and I did that with her. I kept her there. I went to daddy. I changed his drips. I came back to her, means thinking that she should not fall. Now, I didn't know what to do. It's 2 a.m. Whom do I call? If I call my sister, how can she come? If I call her, she'll also get panicked. What shall I do? So up till 2:30 or 2:45, it's a very long time she was unconscious, okay? Very long time that night, that early morning. So then I gave up, okay? And I said, like, let me call my sister, because I was afraid now that in her unconscious state, something wrong should not happen to her. And then my sister would ask me, why didn't you tell me at least once? So I was doing this juggling, like, you know, going to daddy, coming to her, going to daddy, coming to her. So I did this. At last, I gave a call to my sister. And now, the moment I said, Angela, you know, I said Angela, and mummy came to her senses. So mummy saying, Baba, wait. She just told me, wait 1 minute. And she literally, I heard her voice. And then I told my sister, Angela, nothing. I said, actually, mummy had got a cramp. She went unconscious. So I'll keep. She's fine. I just said that. And now what to do? I cannot put her on the ground again. Okay. Now there was a picture of Jesus right in front of on my altar. And daddy's sleeping right there. The bed is right there. Now, even without being in the word of God, I looked at that picture of Jesus and I started talking to him. I never knew I could talk to Jesus. But I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit, he's very nice. Even if we are not in the word, he talks to us. And I started talking to Jesus and I said, and you know how I was talking? Like I'm talking to, like if I will just ask you, like personally, like if I want a favor from you, I'll say, Brother Andre, please, can you do this for me? Sister Jessica, can you do this for me? Please, I need a favor. You know, that types. I started talking to Jesus that type. And I said, Jesus, please come no. Please come no. I want to pull this bed out. Please come no, Jesus. I don't know. It is very heavy and daddy is on the bed. How can I pull out? Come no, Jesus. I remember my words so very clearly. So very clearly. And when I touched that bed underneath to pull it out, it came like a marble, like wheels, like, you know, it just pulled out. I didn't have trouble at all. I said, my gosh, I said, did I do this? And really, I thanked the Lord at that time. I said, wow, Jesus, thank you so much. It was like he, for me, he came out of that picture and he put his hand and he pulled the bed along with me. Okay, it was for me like that. And then fatafat, I put all the bedding for my mama on the bed. I put that extra cushion and all whatever we had made. And now she was already in that conscious state. I brought her back and I put her on the bed. I said, mommy, you sleep here now. I said, and from today, we will not put this bed inside. Let it be out. So I thank the Holy Spirit for bringing to mind, after a very long time, I remember this incident. Even without we knowing the love of God, God himself shows that, you know, I am there for you. So this is like, if he can do that, even without knowing him, without knowing his word, without knowing his scripture, then how much more when we meditate on his word, keep his promise in our heart. And now when we speak to him with that scripture, with that promise, that was Joel 3:10 that day. Lord, I am weak. I am strong in your weakness. It is that what, you know, what came to my mind. That's why that incident suddenly came to me. So how much more can we actually do by learning the scriptures, by studying the scriptures? So let us understand this, my dear brothers and sisters. Because now, you know what, the devil veils our eyes so much that we can't see the love of God. You know, even after that, I was not in the word of God. I never understood. That's why I never get irritated mostly on people who can't understand. I need to only pray to God. because the devil is so sharp, he does not allow them to, that, you know, that they are into that darkness. Even many people who are in the word of God, still they panic. Why? Because the hold of that evil one is not gone. He is trying to keep that veil on them, and they need to break that veil only. And that veil can be broken only by the Holy Spirit. When you show your desire, no, Holy Spirit, I don't want to be anymore in this. I want to come out of that. And now when you show your desire, the Holy Spirit works for you. I didn't, even after seeing that miracle, okay, still I was into that blinded world. It took me years after that. Even after that happened, I could have easily understood, array, if I talk to Jesus every day like this, my life will change. But it didn't happen only that way. Only when I needed, I looked at him and I got convicted by the Holy Spirit. And so it really depends on us. How much are we desiring the word of God? How much do we want to learn the word of God? How much do we want to study the word of God? And today when the Lord has opened my eyes and my spiritual senses, I thank the Lord for inclining me to his word. I thank him a lot for inclining me, for removing that veil from my eyes. Pray for this, my dear brothers and sisters, that the veil be removed from our eyes. Because even if we are spiritually in, if we think that, no, I am doing this in the word, I am doing that, yet the enemy comes to put that cover on you. And you say, no, it's not happening with me. Why am I still into this problem? Because the enemy has still put that veil on us. Unless and until we now sit and meditate and look over that scripture, conceive that scripture in our hearts, and now talk about that Roma tongue, and now we activate that spiritual force by meditating on it, focusing on it again and again and again and again and again and again. One full day with that scripture. Now we see that word of God becoming flesh in our lives. It has to. It has to become flesh. Not it will become. It has to become flesh because it is alive. It is active. The word of God is alive and active. It is sharper than a double-edged sword. Whatever it is, it has to. It only depends on how much have you kept it in your heart. How much are you speaking it out of your mouth by faith? How much are you visualizing that particular scripture coming to pass in your life, that you are not looking at your physical state, but you are looking into the spiritual realm, and you are looking that not only for you, you can do it for your loved one. You can do it for your children, for your spouse, for your sibling, for your colleague, for your job, for everything. It can be done. So please, let us do it. The Lord has kept it very simple. We are the ones who make things difficult for us. He's kept it very simple. His instructions are very simple. He's saying, just can you take that and meditate on it? Just as you meditate a doctor's report, can you now take my word and meditate on it day and night? And now when you're meditating, visualize it, what that word can do for you. When Brother Andre speaks 58:11, a water garden, I just missed that scripture, brother. Is it 58:11? You know, when that scripture says that we are like watered garden, we see each and every bones of us like water lubricated. Look at yourself from the word of God. And yes, that will help us to come out. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Praise you, Jesus. Love you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Yeah, brother, it's 58:11, right?
Yeah, 58:11.
Yeah, thank you, Jesus. Yeah, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you and I praise you for giving us your word. Oh Lord, thank you for bringing to my mind the remembrance of how you came to help when I really needed you. And even today, Lord, though you have forgiven my sins by faith, I believe it. Yet when I remember those days, I still ask forgiveness of not acknowledging and not knowing you, not seeking you at that moment. Lord, in the same way, There are many brothers and sisters of mine who can see your glory, who can see what you do in their lives, what you have done supernaturally for somebody else. But yet, when we do not perceive, when we do not seek, the devil blinds our eyes. He keeps us there only. He keeps us at square one only. He blinds us by making us understand that no, we are doing many things in the world. We are attending lot of sessions. We are attending lot of mass. We are attending lot of rosaries. But yet he blinds us, Lord. He keeps us over there only. He keeps us to show us that, see, after you doing so much also, you are not come out of this trouble. Because we have somewhere lacked in acknowledging your word by acknowledging his word. Lord, from today, as we understand that it is not we who have to acknowledge him, but acknowledge your written word. Keep your written word in front of our eyes. Meditate on your written word, on that document that you have given us, on that promise that you have given us in front of our eyes. Visualize ourselves in what you have told us to be. And now when we see that, when our audio and our video, that is when our word of the mouth and when the visualizing of our spiritual mind meets and becomes one, we get that manifestation into our lives, not only for ourselves, but even for our loved ones. Yes, Lord. Thank you so much, O Holy Spirit of God, for bringing to mind every remembrance that we learn. Thank you, Jesus, and praise you, Jesus. As I have spoken these words, I believe and I receive, Lord, that all that is spoken is received by your children on this forum, and they and their families, their lives are flourishing in every good health. And thank you, Lord, for they are coming back with testimonies on the meditation on the word of God. This we ask in the most mighty and glorious name. And all God's people said, amen, 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 and amen. Thank you,
amen.
Jesus.
Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, sister. Very powerful teaching.
Thank you, sister.
Thank you, sister.